What a complete shift is this for the gaming industry? Because consumers are going to be able to use it, but what does it mean for the actual studios too?
Yeah, it's massive. It's a big change in the same way that AI was a big change for Hollywood as well. And now it's important to understand and recognize the two parts of how AI is affecting games. On the one end, you have the real-time rendering component of it that we're working towards, which basically means you're going to be able to create pixels in a real-time manner. And the other one is the mechanics, right? So how do games manifest itself? What are the interactions that users would have with them, from consumers to pretty much everyone? And so Game World for us is kind of like an exploration and our first product in the mechanics of non-linear stories with AI, creating these worlds in real time and having players experiment with them.
I mean, I think about the first time that we first started bringing you on the show and hearing from how much you were, well, disrupting Hollywood, but Hollywood has now come to embrace you, using Amazon, using it in the latest works that they're doing and creating, Cristóbal. How has the gaming studio reaction been? Has it been bristling or has it been accepting?
It's somehow very similar to what I think Hollywood went through a year and a half ago. I think it's totally new. It takes time. But now I think most of them have started to embrace it and understand it. It's a radical technology. It changes how you do your work. You need to embrace it. You need to understand it. There's things that work really well. There's some things that don't really work really well. But really, it's about like using it more. And so I would say that games and the gaming world is where I would say Hollywood was a year ago. And now, as models progress, get better, become more usable, you start seeing most of those companies now starting to adopt it.
I mean, you can see the impact because it's being used in features by big tech companies and big filmmakers, Cristóbal. But how are you measuring impact for those that are about to take it on? Look, we're all talking about this MIT study about whether or not 95% of these pilots for generative AI are failing. How do you prove out that your technology adds value?
Yeah, well, you have to make sure that it helps users somehow. And look, there's a challenge. And I think the challenge that I think media and Hollywood recognize over time is these are not tools that will make movies for you. And I think that was a big assumption at the time where like many people thought you just came into Runway, type movie, and you get a movie out. Unfortunately, that's not yet what the technology is doing. It's much more about you being in control and you spending the right time. But also you need to rewire your brain a little bit. You need to retrain the mental models of how this technology can help you. And that takes time. And so how we manage through that change with our companies and customers and users is we help them. Sometimes we go and work alongside them. We have technical artists that you can think about them as like four deploy engineers that sit together with our companies and users and enterprises and help them understand how Runway can fit in particular parts of their workflow. Your Aleph, for example, is our latest video generation model that allows you to edit video in ways that you just couldn't do before. And it works completely different from anything you've seen before. And so it's not going to work based on what you know. There's an adjustment period. And that adjustment period is critical. For me, it's very similar to perhaps how the cloud was a big change for companies. Like, it requires you to redo and reorganize some of your teams to prepare for this.
I'm talking about reorganizing teams. I mean, Mark Zuckerberg's been busy at that. And we understand that previously he'd perhaps eyed up Runway, wanting to be able to buy that to bring in for the AI prowess. You knocked it back. That's off the table. But how many offers are you getting for Runway? And how are you comforting your employees that you might not jump ship?
Again, I've been working on this for like almost 7-8 years. And I think we're now hitting an interesting inflection point. It's getting too exciting for us to like think about not being independent. Like, we want to remain independent. We have the resources we need. We have the best team in the world doing some of the best research in the world. Now is an inflection point in both quality, adoption, penetration. It's a really exciting time to build Runway. And I think there's still a long way to go for us.